sorry, Marlene. Now, go on, get back to the laundry. Go on.
What's wrong? You look real sick.
What's going on?
Now, come on now. Everybody back to work.
They're sending you away to Salma. They weren't going to tell you.
Nah, you must have it wrong. I mean, they would have told us, eh?
Is that true? Transfers were where to?
Look, I've not seen the orders yet. No, that's all I can tell you.
Yeah. You expecting the police?
No.
You taking Vasty?
They're subsidising your escape, mate. $3,000 to waste.
Right, fellas, let's have you.
Well, so long, Mr. Crookshank. It's been short but sweet.
Goodbye, McCrae. Hope the lad's okay.
Come on, let's get
just
going, shall we?
Just where do you think of taking these men?
Transfer.
On whose orders? The department calls.
Sit up! Look out!
I shot him down.
No, man, you don't know that. You don't even know if it's got anything to do with the fellas.
I knew he'd try something. I could see it in his face.
Oh, he'll be all right, Marlene. Take it easy.
Why can't they tell us what's going on?
Killers talk cost lives, dear.
What?
I think they're keeping it all hush-hush. I reckon it's commando raid, if you ask me.
Gee, someone shut her up, will ya?
You bastards, you pay for this!
Come on,
Bert! Shut your mouth, you're a loser,
Bert! Oh, I knew I shouldn't have signed those papers. I tried to check, but I couldn't get onto anyone who could help.
It's all right, Joyce. I dare say the same thing could have happened to me in similar circumstances.
Probably wouldn't have happened at all if I hadn't practically confirmed to the newspapers that the men were even here.
Yes, that was a little indiscreet.
But Mr. Colby's after my blood.
Well, he wasn't exactly jumping for joy when he left here. He wants a full report on his desk in the morning.
I did try to check it out, Mrs. Reynolds. The department was supposed to phone me back.
You'll get a chance to explain that in your report. Just make sure it's complete in every detail.
Yes, I'll get onto it right away. Joan and Dennis behaved extremely well, didn't they?
They did. I never thought I'd be grateful for Joan's stand on the arms issue, but just this once I thank God for her tenacity.
I never thought of that. Imagine if they'd been unarmed. God, I'd never have forgiven myself.
Gutless pommy, if you hadn't ever done it,
you're not sorry. What's going on?
Get off me, you
gutless! Shut up!
What about Harvey? Gonna leave me like this, are you?
Okay. We'll try and be clever.
Watch him.
You've been in a Barnsley pub, you know not to try that.
You bastards! I'll give a lot of you!
Aye, lad, of course you will, but not just yet, eh?
What was all the fireworks about?
Mind your business, Deacon, and get moving unless you want to stay here.
Thank you. What was all that shooting?
Big shot in there, trying to organise a way out for himself.
Anybody get hurt?
A couple of villains who dressed themselves up as coppers. They're in hospital.
God.
It makes my gut curdle every time I hear a gun go off.
Yeah, oh, sure as anyone's with half a brain, Judy.
You heard what Mr. Churchill had to say the other night, and I think that our boys
are doing... For God's sake, Etty, please, give it a rest, love. No one is going to take Wentworth.
Well, I wouldn't bet your pants on it. Those Germans can be very...
Hey, what is this, a stop work meeting, huh?
Well, great to have you back, love. You OK?
Oh, yeah, anything's better than that hole, I can tell you.
Oh, Jude, it's so nice to see you back. Oh,
did you hear anything about the shooting?
Yeah, it was Frank Burke who was trying to escape. They put him in the pound.
Was anyone hurt?
A couple of guys got hurt.
I knew it. Matthew!
No, it wasn't Matt, love. It was a couple of guys posing as cops, you know, to get him out. They're the ones that got hurt.
Anybody else?
No, Matt and Jeff are OK. Anyway, Cruikshank said that the freak was behaving like a regular Annie Oakley. Oh, it's all right, love.
Oh, a nice cry out to the world of good.
And the other two, they've been transferred to Woodridge?
Yeah, it's all a scam. They're still here.
You wouldn't kid us.
No.
Oh, I'm glad Lexi's not here. I mean, Karen, I'm like a scalded chook for nothing.
He was screaming blue bloody murder when the pom shut him in. Too bad he didn't make it.
Thought he was dirty on.
If he'd have made it, we'd have been shot of him. He's nothing but trouble.
Reckon he'll try to get back in for his chop of the scam when they let him out?
He'll get his chop all right.
Hell, where'd you get that?
Pinched it from Greenway. Sharpened up real good with a bit of work.
Nice. Should be able to carve Burke's grin right off his face with that.
With pleasure. But he's number two on my list. The first one's gonna be Desmond.
Right, just stand on the white line, dear.
Oh, dear.
Sorry. Oh, it's my fault.
Oh, you're having one of those days, are you?
Yes, you could say that.
Look, I wouldn't get too close if I were you. Bit on the nose.
Right. Now just answer yes or no. Your name is Sheila Maureen Brady, is that correct?
Yeah.
And you've been remanded in custody on a charge of illegal possession of a drug of addiction, is that correct?
Yeah.
Right. Thanks.
You're welcome, believe me.
Now, I think we'll change the routine here a little. I'm sure you'd like a nice hot shower before we go any further.
If you want.
Right, well, we'll put your effects under the counter and then go through them after we've finished, OK?
You mean what?
Your personal effects, your personal things here.
Oh, sorry. I can keep my guitar with me though, can't I?
Well, we'll have to check it for contraband, but yes, we can have it back after that.
Hey, can you be a little bit more careful with it?
Yes, Brady. I'll be very careful.
Told the kids were really stoked with it. Here's the card they sent as a thank you.
Oh, isn't that cute?
Yeah.
Look. Ah, look at all the writing too. Well, there you are, you see. Some good did come out of it after all.
I think I got just a bigger buzz as they did.
You're really hurting, aren't you?
You know, June, I've been thinking, having a handicap like that, well, not being able to hear, would make you more aware of moods and faces. Help you understand people better, don't you think?
I think that if you talked about this, you would feel better.
It's nothing to talk about.
You shouldn't have arrived on your mother's doorstep just like that, love. Maybe if you'd given her a bit of warning.
She's not my mother. You worry too much, Jude. How can I miss something I've never had? So you see, there's no problem. Oh, geez, Ma, would you quit the nervous bit? You're putting me off. What's bugging you anyhow?
I don't know. Everything. I bet they're in the hospital. Or the pound.
Who?
Matt and Jeff. I bet they really did get shot. Mr. C just told us that so we wouldn't have a riot or something.
Look, I think you're way off beam, Rabbit.
Oh, yeah? That's because you...
G'day, Mal.
I thought...
Well, I...
Oh, Lex, could you keep knit or something?
Yeah, I get the message.
Don't get the feeling that we're kicking you out or nothing, Lex.
Three's a crowd, right? You know, this one's been just about paying herself with worry about you.
Oh, Lexi!
Well, there's nothing wrong with that. Let the red hot lovers get on with it, eh?
She's right. I was worried sick.
Oh. No need now, Mal. Oh, jeez. You don't know how glad I am they didn't transfer us.
transfer you. I'm just glad they didn't bloody shoot you. I thought I'd never see you again.
Gotta be honest, are you? I'm glad they didn't ship you off to Woodridge, but maybe it would have been better in the long run.
How do you mean?
Not much future for us here, is there?
Let's just take each day as it comes and enjoy it while we can.
Yeah, you're right. Don't mind me. I think the shooting affected me more than I thought.
Getting a bit matey, aren't you?
Crack off, Kelly.
What's the matter, Lou? You're trying to leave without telling you. Guess I struck a nerve.
Maybe we are being a bit obvious.
Yeah, let's see if we can find a less public place soon.
Washed
out. Oh, it's been a rough couple of days.
Oh, yeah. Well, at least the bastard got what he deserved.
Yeah, doesn't stop me feeling sick every time I think of it. Some of the women, too. Treat me like Jack the Ripper.
I'm afraid that's the way it goes. Bea got pretty much the same treatment when she branded Nola McKenzie. We'll get over it, don't worry.
It's me I'm wondering about.
Could I have your attention, please, ladies? This is Sheila Brady. I'd like you all to help her settle in.
Hi.
Oh, hello, dear. I'll introduce you around.
She's very smelly, I'm afraid. No clean clothes. Make sure they all go through the laundry.
No worries, Mrs. Bell.
You into bands, eh?
No, just hung out with them for a while.
What do you mean, hung out?
I live with them. Into the groupie scene, then?
No, I just hung around with them. That's all. Just
hey, do you ever get to meet any of the top bands?
No, bands I know are lucky to get
covered. Oh, do they play any marches? It's very popular right now. They're very patriotic.
Hello, I'm Marlene. This is Matthew.
This is Sheila.
Hi.
What's that stink?
Could I have your attention for a moment, please? I won't keep you long. I've been told there's some talk around that there's going to be a change of governor. I just wanted to tell you personally, it's true.
Oh, what?
Bloody lady.
Oh, wow.
Oh, here, Meg, I'll tell you that.
Thanks. Now, I'm not an invalid, you know.
Oh, won't do you any harm to take it easy for a bit, eh?
Yes, that's something I can get used to very easily. Tell me, have you heard anything from Heather since you came back?
No, she seems to have vanished off the face of the earth. I won't give up till I find her, though. That bloody Ferguson woman. Oh, sorry, Meg, I'm here to cheer you up. Not bring you down to my depressed state.
Wow, what's the matter?
Thanks. No, I don't know. You've heard about Anne leaving, though?
Yes, it depressed me, too. I suppose Joan's rubbing her hands together.
No, it's very odd. She's going around telling everyone she hasn't got a hope in hell of getting it.
I wonder what she's up to.
My feelings exactly. I put a bit of a spoke in her wheel, though.
Oh?
Hmm. I told her I'd applied. You should have seen her face. I mean, I don't expect to get it, but at least it gave me a bit of interview experience.
Yes, I'm afraid they will be looking for someone with more experience this time up.
Right. Looks like you're a certainty for it, then.
Oh, no, don't wish that on me. I mean, I wouldn't accept it even if the department handed it to me.
Oh, come on, Meg.
No, I couldn't. I'm just not well enough. I mean, with the run I've had lately, I couldn't handle the extra workload or the responsibility.
Well, I understand how you feel, but Joan would be a dead cert for it, then. Well, that's bad enough for us officers, but, I mean, what about the poor women?
I know. I wonder if there's a way we could get Anne to change her mind.
Do you think that's possible? I mean, she's convinced herself it's best for everyone that she moves on.
Oh, I don't know, Dan. There must be a way.
Hi. Do you mind if I come in?
Well, help yourself.
What'd you think of the tucker?
Not very worse.
Sorry you had to sit by yourself. I didn't even notice till I was almost finished.
That's okay. Nobody knows me. I didn't expect him to sit with me anyway.
Hey, sorry about that crack I made in the rec room. I didn't know it was you. I wasn't meaning to be nasty or anything.
I swear.
So how did you get to know all those rock groups?
I don't know. I just got talking to the first lot, and then they just introduced me around to their mates.
Did you work for them or what?
No. I always got a feed, half a bed, and a few other things. Till this lot got jacking me anyway.
Oh, you had a blue with them, eh?
Just got sick of me, I guess. Now they only have me around after a while so I could carry their dope for them.
They made you carry drugs.
No, no. No one made me. It was just something to do. That's what got me in here. I was sprung, holding smack.
You weren't, taking it too, were you?
No. I never had the dough to get into that scene. Anyhow, the couple of times I mainlined, it just made me feel crook. Now, Benny's are the things that turned me on. They were great. You know, all I had to do was just drop a few of them, and I used to be able to get the gang to laugh.
Oh.
You know, I didn't feel so much like a dipstick. You know. And grass was just a downer. It put me to sleep.
Oh, I never take anything like that. It'd be just as well my parents would kill me if they found out.
Yeah. It's the truth. Mine wouldn't. I don't even know where they are.
Don't you have anybody that cares about what happens to you?
The bloke that gave me this must have thought I was okay. Davey was nice. It's the only time I ever got a real present. So he must have cared, mustn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, it's a really great guitar.
Yeah.
All right, Deacon, what's on your mind?
Look, I don't blame you for being dirty on me, but it wasn't my fault. I didn't know Lou was going to try to set you up.
Oh, pull the other one, it rings.
Oh, you've got to believe me, Myra. I've had it with Lou. I want to throw in with you.
What exactly is this all about?
Please, Myra, you don't know what she's going to do to me. What?
I ought to finish you off right now, Keller.
You haven't got the guts.
Oh, no, it's not that. I'm going to rot in jail for the rest of my life. It's not going to be for a slut like you.
Sounds great, Jim.
Oh, thanks, love, but Carole King, I'm not.
As your attitude becomes Sam? Practical, you can.
Do me a favour, will you? Keep this well hidden in future.
I could lend you some woolen needles if you like. They're always knitting socks in the army.
You okay?
No, not really.
Keep the chin up.
Myra, look, can't you get me something, anything? Just one drink and I'll be fine after that.
You won't.
But I will. I won't ask for another one. I won't need another one.
Jan. Look, you're an alcoholic. I know you're in a lot of pain.
I'm not an alcoholic.
I'm telling you. Now, the only way you can prove you're not an alcoholic is to lay off the grog. If you can't cope with that, I'm going to go straight to the governor.
Hey, aren't you going to show me those drawings?
Oh, I'd rather not, Jan.
Oh, come on, love. It can't be that bad.
It's not bad. It's just that I feel as if my drawings are an illustration of my deepest thoughts. To show you would be like showing you everything that's in my mind, I guess.
Okay, I can understand that. I feel that way about my songs.
Yeah.
Oh, is that what you call them? I've heard better at a kindergarten picnic.
Yeah, well, with the juvenile mentality, it'd be hard to tell the difference, wouldn't it?
And just watch your mouth, Greenway. Pick up that rubbish before I put you on a charge.
I was born on Black Friday, and they put a spell on me.
ain't fair. And if hard luck were diamonds, you know I'd be a millionaire. I'd be a millionaire.
On you now. Look, calm down.
At least they'd give me a drink, wouldn't they? When I see what shape I'm in, at least they'd give me a drink.
Oh, come on, you can't pack it in to come this far. Come on.
I just think you better leave me alone.
Not bloody likely. Old Eddie might have been on the end of the queue when they're giving brains out, but she does not let her mates down.
Reason why you weren't in the shower, Brady?
Oh, I had one yesterday, Mr. Crookshank.
Oh, it's not good enough, lass. We expect you to shower every day.
Oh, I'm sorry. Will I do it now?
No, we don't want you to miss breakfast. You can have one afterwards. And get this mess straightened up, eh?
Mess?
No, these clothes and the bed.
I'm sorry, but I'm not with you. What's wrong with it?
Well, it hasn't been made, has it? We expect the cells to be kept clean and tidy, and that includes making the bed.
I'm sorry, Mr. Crookshank, but I wouldn't know where to start.
What do you mean to say? You've never made a bed before? Well, surely somebody must have... Okay. I'll do it for you, once. And then it's up to you, all right? Now, first of all, straighten out the sheet. Okay, then you fold the blanket under. All right, pull it out. Tuck it in. Like so. Right, straighten the top out. Smooth it out. Tuck it in. That's about all there is to it, really.
Gee, that looks just the way you see them in the books. It's really beautiful.
And it's also what we expect to see every morning, okay?
Yeah, okay, I'll try.
Right. Now, hang these clothes up. And I'll consider inspection passed. Oh, and don't forget to have that shower, will you?
Then you can have brekkie with the rest of us.
I don't think I could, Eddie.
Oh, nonsense. Some good, solid food will do you the world of good.
She's right. You've got to keep up your strength.
Oh, well, I wouldn't do for a drink.
I thought we said last night we wouldn't even think about that.
There's got to be another way. Can't you give me something? Just anything. Just something for the pain.
There is no other way. It's for your own good, remember?
Yes. I've been trying to convince myself of the same thing all night.
Come on, let's make you presentable.
I'll get it, Clara.
What do you get? We'll slap a bit of war paint on so the screws don't catch
on. I don't know how you put up with me. I've been nothing but trouble since I got here.
Oh, nonsense. You aren't the trouble, it's the booze that's the problem.
You're lucky you've got someone like Eddie to look after you. A lot of people haven't got anybody.
Oh, my God. Who's that? Oh, there's no way that the officers aren't going to notice. Oh, look, Myra, I've aged 10 years.
Come on, we'll fix you up.
These clothes will make the world of difference.
Hey, come on, you're on the home stretch.
Yeah, I know. Winning post in sight. I just hope I can last the distance.
The fact is, she'd never seen a bed properly made before.
Oh, and you made it for her, huh?
Well, somebody had to show the girl. How else would she learn?
Poor thing. It's shocking the way some people are forced to live nowadays.
No.
Morning, everyone.
Oh, Meg, it is nice to see you back.
You were feeling better?
Yes, I am, thank you. And how's everything here?
Oh, we were just talking about one of the new inmates. Here, look, get your coffee.
Oh, thank you. Well, which one? I saw the list of new arrivals at reception.
Her name's Sheila Brady.
She's on remand for possession, isn't she?
Hmm, that's her. Oh, she's a sad case.
Oh?
The trouble is, she's got such a low opinion of herself, and Well, let's just say that her and Soap are complete strangers.
Let's face it, she's an all-round no-hoper. Typical junkie.
How you can make that sort of statement, John, just from someone's appearance is really beyond me.
Because, Mr. Crookshank, I happen to believe that presentation reflects the person. A disciplined mind knows the value of organisation and cleanliness.
Unfortunately, not everyone has had the opportunity to be taught that, Miss Ferguson.
As far as I'm concerned, Mrs. Barry, this is a prison, not a finishing school for young ladies, so don't expect me to teach her.
Consistency. Oh, that's what I love about this place.
What's wrong with you this morning? You haven't touched a thing. Your food.
Oh, sorry. I've got something on my mind.
Now, let me see, what could that be? Is it someone 24 years old whose first initial is M?
Someone like that.
Oh, talk about lovesick.
It's not very good being in here while he's on the other city.
Oh, bring out the violins. Warren's doing a pixie. Shut up. Lost your sense of humor, Brian. Where pixie is concerned, yes, I have, so you cut it out.
Hey, do you know where Mara's birthday is? It's Taurus, so it must be really close.
No. All I know is that it's soon and it's the big one. 40. No wonder she's hiding it.
40? What's wrong with 40? It can't be that bad.
Well, it can't be that good either, and believe me, I ought to know.
Dude, you don't look that old.
I know, I look older, right?
Oh, 60.
Uh-oh, here comes Stink Bomb. Hi.
Did she not notice it?
Well, you don't notice it if you're like that all the time.
Anyone see her in the shower this morning?
No. I can tell you one thing, though. Someone's going to have a little talk with her.
Oh, shoot. No.
Take a deep breath, guys. Here she comes.
Want to sit in?
Sure.
Well, you picked a good morning, didn't you? These eggs are terrific, huh?
Yeah.
That's all it's made. I always reckon food was just food.
Yeah, food's just food. Sheila.
Excuse me, this is very brief.
Hang on a minute. I'm going to talk this through now, okay? Sheila, we like you very much. We do, we like you a lot. But you've got a problem, and I think we should work this out now.
What do you mean?
She means you stink.
Oh, Lexi.
There's nothing that can't be fixed.
That's right. There's nothing that can't be fixed. Just more showers. Use some deodorant and stuff, you know? Hasn't anyone ever told you about this before?
No. Is that what you meant last night? I'll just go and have a shower, then.
Hey, Sheila, it's...
Why
from Rock?
What? Yeah, so do I. Damn it.
You're right.
Damn, Marlene, keep knit.
Oh,
hang in there, love, come on.
Screw!
Oh, that's all we bloody need. Can you straighten up, please?
Lexi, stay with her, just
for hours. Yeah, and the others try and cover. Get back to work.
Great to see you back.
How are you feeling?
I'm fine.
Good.
Actually, I really missed the place.
Oh, I know exactly how you feel. I still miss Barnhurst.
You must be Etty Parsley.
Yes, that's right. Oh, you're new here, are you?
Not quite, no.
Oh, Mrs. Morgan. Well, if you'll excuse me, it's my turn to take the skip out.
Right. Actually, it's Morris.
Oh, Morris Morgan. What a funny name for a girl. We have got a Barry here too, you know. No. Her name's Mrs. Barry. Oh, well, I must go. Can't keep waiting any longer.
Mrs. Morris, can I see you for a minute?
Yes, what is it?
Oh, it's private, actually. Do you think we could...
Right. Back to work, please.
Yeah, nice to see you.
Yeah.
Well,
it seems to be the problem. Mara's birthday, we're trying to find out the date. See, she's Taurian, which means it must be really...
Right. Yes, well, I'm sure we can manage that.
Thanks. We want to make it really special for us.
Yes. Very nice thought. Now, actually, you can do me a favour. Will you tell Etty that my name is Morris and not Morgan?
No worries.
Perhaps if you took a couple of deep breaths, huh?
Oh, God, I've seen people on smack come down better than this.
Good thinking, Rab. You got her out in the nick of time.
Sure, I can survive him. Just for God's sake, Rin, someone get me a drink.
Come on, you know we can't do this.
Myra, you've got to. I've had enough. My body can't take any more.
Oh, good heavens.
Oh, hi, Eddie.
What are you doing down there?
I'm having a sleep.
But it's daytime, dear. Anyway, what's the matter with the bed?
Nothing. It's the trouble. It looks so nice, I didn't want to ruin it. But I had a shower, though, like Jude said.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, well, would you mind telling her and the others for me? I don't want to cause any more hassles.
Of course I will. Now, look, while I'm here, why don't you put all your clothes in the skip and I'll get them a turn in the washing machine.
No, save yourself the trouble, eh?
Oh, it's no trouble. All the other girls have put theirs in.
Yeah, but look, I've only worn these a few times. You only make an extra work for yourself.
If you say so.
Hey, Ed. How do you hack this place, Ed? I mean, it mustn't be much fun at your age.
Oh, well, you see, I'm getting out soon. They're retiring me off.
Retiring?
Mm.
Oh, yeah, fair enough.
Now, look, you get off your bum and do something. The sleeping in the daytime is just not good enough. There are always things to do if you look for them.
What's wrong with sleeping? It helps pass the time.
No, it's a waste of time. Do something. Make yourself useful.
Like what? I couldn't even handle a job putting lids on cardboard boxes when I was outside.
Well, I don't know then, dear. Read a book.
No. No, I tried that once. It's a bit hard to concentrate when you're living with musos.
Musos? What are they?
Musicians.
Oh, I always loved that Beethoven chap. He's the one that wrote that musical they keep showing on television. Or was that somebody else? Oh, well, can't hang around here any longer. See you later.
Bye, Eddie.
What to do about Myra's birthday?
We should book a room at the Hilton, throw her a party, eh?
Hey, that's an idea. Surprise party.
Well, you reckon she'd go for it?
Doesn't seem like the party type to me.
Well, that's just because she's having hassles with Jan at the moment. No, I reckon that's the go. Surprise party it is.
How's it going, Brian?
None the better for you being here, Kelly.
It's a public place. I reckon we've all got a right to know what little gems you're coming up with. Right, Kat?
Yeah, we don't like selfish people. Why don't you two just get lost, huh?
Sure.
So, oh, give what? That back!
Oh, thinking of words makes me so happy.
Come on, give it
to me. I stand with strangers by my side.
What are you upset about, Yank?
You two.
Thought you'd want everyone to know what you're writing about.
Keep your nose out of people's business. I'm not concerned. You
give it back.
Well, she's warning you, Kat.
Oh, yeah, I'm scared.
Look, come on.
It's very rude, Greenway.
Yeah? So what are you going to do about it, huh?
Yeah. We'd like to know too, Lou.
She's out of college, Jude. I think they're great news.
Yeah, Kelly wouldn't know a good song if she fell over one.
Too right.
Well, she succeeded in getting my back up anyway, didn't she?
Do you want me to write it out again for you? It's in a bit of a mess.
No, I'll do it.
Are you sure? It's no trouble. How are you, Jude? Are you okay?
I'm fine, Sam. Sorry, don't you have something you can do? I'll just write this out.
You're not going to let him get away with it, are you?
Yeah, it was worth it just to see the look on the Yank's face.
Oh, but the word's going to get round we back down.
Big deal. They'll come crawling back once we finish with Desmond.
Desmond? We just tried that and look where it got us. And how lucky were you she didn't stick you with that bloody knife?
Lucky be buggered. That's why she'll never win.
She's too soft.
Geez, I don't know, Lou. She may be soft, but she's no damn pushover. Well, what about the women backing her up?
You're not thinking of pulling out, are you?
I didn't say that.
Good. So I'm going to show that bitch that I can give as good as I can get. And more. Jude.
Should ask Reno if Jude can have a piano. We can sell that by morons like Kelly can't even.
Into a cell
God, you get some crazy ideas, Rabbit.
What the hell are you doing?
Oh, nothing. I was just checking your tapes to see what music you'd got.
See which ones you could rip off, you mean.
Oh, I wasn't, honest.
Take it easy, Lex. Give her a go.
No way, stupid bitch. You keep your mitts off in future, okay?
There's no need to be nasty about it.
It's okay, Marlene. I'm sorry.
And while you're at it, go take another shower. You pong worse than a camel driver's armpit.
Why did you have to go and say that for?
Because it's true.
Yeah, well, she hates herself enough without you adding to it. If you weren't such a know-all, you wouldn't always think the worst of people.
Oh, talk about Warren in Wonderland.
Oh, that's right. Now pick on me. I'm beginning to think it's easier being enemies with you than friends.
Suit yourself. But don't come running to me when the real world comes crashing down on
don't
top of you.
Don't worry. I won't.
What do you want?
Come to talk to you about Jude. Look, I don't care what you say about me. Just lay off Jude. I said lay off Jude.
Oh, what?
Oh. Now! You can tell fat guts from me that if you're the heavy artillery, he's got real trouble. Got it? I said, got it? Oh. I'd stick to painting if I were you. I mean, you got nothing else going for you, have you?
So me dad knocks the frisbee craze right on the head because of all the broken windows. And then along comes the roller skates.
What? Not you on roller skates. You'd have to be followed around with the safety
net.
Believe these two. They weren't even talking to each other at lunchtime.
Takes all time.
Sure does.
I'll give you a hand, Jude.
I think I can handle this myself.
I've been dying to tell you. It's tomorrow.
What?
Tomorrow's birthday. Mrs. Emma found out.
Hey, Jude, can I talk to you for
a minute? In a minute.
It doesn't give us much. I've got everything planned. We just have to ask permission.
Jude?
Well, I don't remember calling a smoker, but what the hell? Who's got a light?
This isn't a smoker. We're just having a small chat here. That's
helping.
All.
Oh, right. Well, don't let me interrupt. I'm working.
Damn.
Here, let me.
How can I sew straight with hands like this?
Try zigzag. Just a joke.
You better go into something else, love. I can't risk you having an accident.
I'll take it. I think you've been arrested.
Slacking off, ladies? Surely not, with Desmond in charge. Ah, that's better. Grant, you've got a visitor.
Miss Ferguson, I've got to see the governor.
Is that so? Well, why don't you try again tomorrow when you learn to say please?
Please, Miss Ferguson, it's urgent.
Oh, well, right. Wait at the security gate. I'll get someone to take you. I told you lot to get on with it.
Well, there's no point in asking what all that was about. It's obviously none of my business.
Oh, come on, Myra, please.
Jude.
Oh, sorry, love. You wanted to say something.
I was trying to get back at you over that carry-on before lunch.
How do you know that?
Well, I overheard her talking. I tried to warn her off, but she wouldn't.
You tried to warn her off? Are you out of your mind?
I'm trying to stop her hurting you, Jude.
I can look after myself. And I certainly don't need someone like you playing bodyguard and getting hurt in the process, do you understand? Now, I mean it, Samantha. You let people that can handle these things do it.
Give you an elephant stamp for neatness, did they?
It wasn't me. Mr. Cruikshank made it.
Got the screws making your bed for you. Not bad.
I hear they got you for possession. Been getting into the hard stuff, have you?
Who told you that?
Come on. They don't chuck you in the slammer for peddling tea leaves, sweetheart.
Oh, I've never really used it. It was just my luck getting caught with some.
Oh, pull the other one. Once a junkie, always a junkie.
I just picked up a few freebies from my mates, that's all. Didn't seem to help much anyway.
Some of the women in here reckon it's the only thing that gets them through the day.
How can they afford it?
Not hard. If you got the right dealer. And I reckon you'd have the right contacts on the outside.
No way. I lost track of everybody as soon as I was busted. Sorry.
Shouldn't have done it. I'm wasting my bloody time. But if you get any ideas about chasing up your old pals and going into business on your own, don't!
Look, I'm not into the stuff. Sorry.
Do something about that smell, will you? It's been like living in a tip since you've been here.
Do
only reason I hollered at you about Kelly was because I was worried about you.
Couldn't you sit there and do nothing, Jude?
Yeah, you should have come and told me about it and let me handle it instead of rushing off and dealing with it yourself. There's some pretty rough people in this place. I'd never forgive myself if you got hurt over me.
I've been a real fool, haven't I? Can't even help my best friend.
There's only one person you should be helping, Sam, and that's yourself. You're gonna have to try and get your act together.
I try, but everything goes wrong.
All right, honey, all right. You've had a rough patch. We all have those, but they pass. Just try and keep your head above water, because believe me, the only person that is going to help you is yourself.
I know.
Hey, come on. Let's go and play cards or something.
Okay. Just let me scrub up a bit, huh?
Sure. You're gonna be okay, aren't you? Social diary, but I can't take it.
Got everything planned, from the cake to the music to the dancing after.
With Matt Delaney, I'll bet, huh?
He wants to ask.
Oh. I can see it now, Torval and Dean.
Oh, we're having ice as well.
Bloody hell, that wasn't even subtle.
Where's Etty?
Oh, over here, dear. Are you all right? You haven't had bad news,
no,
have you?
No, I'm fine. Look, I want to ask you something. Can you remember how long you've been in here for?
Oh, well, I reckon it was about the time when the fighting first started.
Well, I can tell you exactly, Etty. It's been for 45 years without so much as a trial.
What? Kidding? You sure?
Yes, it's all here.
Oh, well, I suppose the courts are pretty busy these days. You know, backlogs and everything.
Not for 45 years, Etty. But the department's made a bureaucratic bungle. They're going to pay for it.
I don't believe it.
Well, look, don't make too much fuss about it, dear, because I'm due for my retirement
soon. Etty, when you leave here, it's not going to be on a pension. We can sue them for enough money to compensate for those 45 years a dozen times over.
Whoa!
Go for
that's
it, Etty.
That's what I like to hear.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are